Ashura. Finally, the day of Ashura dawned upon the soil of Karbala. It was a day when jihad would be in full bloom, bloodshed would be shed, 72 innocent lives would be sacrificed, and a decisive battle would be won to save Islam and the Ummah. It had been a few days since the water supply was cut off by the enemy. Children were crying for water, the women were desperate for water. Zainul Abidin alayhi salam, the son of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, was sick with fever. The suffering from the thirst was too painful to bear. And despite this, not a single person in the camp made any complaints or even questioned the mission of Imam Hussein. Each member supported the Imam wholeheartedly and enthusiastically. Next morning, Imam Hussein alayhi salam went out of the camp and saw Umar ibn Sa'ad mobilizing his troops to start the hostility. He stared at the intimidating army, and as large as it was, Imam Hussein showed no signs of compromise. Imam Hussein raised his hands in prayer. O Allah, it is Thee in whom I trust amid all grief. You are my hope amid all violence. Thou art my refuge and provision in everything that happens to me. How many grievances weaken the heart, leaving me with no means to handle them, during which friends desert me and enemies rejoice in it. I lay it before Thee and complain of it to Thee because of my desire in Thee, Thee alone. You relieve me of it and remove it from me. Thou art the master of all grace, the essence of goodness, and the ultimate resort of all desire. Before the actual engagement was to take place, Hur, the previous commander of the enemy force, felt his conscience violently stirring. He was in turmoil. Upon realizing the gravity of the situation, he suddenly broke away from Umar ibn Sa'ad's camp along with two others, and they rushed toward Imam Hussein alayhi salam to join his camp. Hur's heart was jumping with joy, his mind relieved of an agonizing tension. Hur's defection worried Umar ibn Sa'ad very much, lest the others do the same and defect. So Umar ibn Sa'ad threw an arrow in the air to indicate the start of the battle. This was the outset of a catastrophe and a tragic event that Muawiyah had once conceived to happen.
شقي ضريحي في تخوم سمائي واحثي النجوم للوعة الزهراء شقي ضريحي في تخوم سمائي واحثي النجوم للوعة الزهراء